At the Seattle Science Foundation, these middle school students are getting a jump on better science scores. They're doing hands-on experiments that tests show will make them better at science.
I like experimenting and finding out things like what happens.
Helping students understand what happens in science is why pediatrician Carol Ashenberg, now a middle school science teacher, is finding creative ways to teach beyond her 800-page textbook.
It's not just sitting there and listening to this direct instruction. The more they're manipulating things and working with each other, I think the more willing they are to ask questions. Again, they somehow absorb it.
American students are absorbing more science, but not by much. Results from the National Assessment of Education Progress, which tested 122,000 sample eighth graders from more than 7,000 schools, found average test scores for students increased only 2 points between 2009 and 2011.
It was hard to get interested in science as a kid because, you know, when you're a kid, you're thinking about doing things and you're thinking about using your hands and interacting, and the traditional way of education doesn't provide you that opportunity.
But new government test results show how and why students are improving their science scores. Eighth graders who reported daily investigations in science scored 16 points higher on average than students who did little or no hands-on activities.
I don't really like just sitting and listening to the teacher tell me things about it. I like the, like, just doing things on my own.
You're going to have to know how to understand since you're actually testing the experiment. If you're just reading, you can read to read, but are you actually understanding the material?
That's a question lots of middle school science teachers will be asking students. The answer will be on our nation's next report card. In Seattle, this is Mark Christopher.